Welcome to the Online Metals Materials Talk Series. My name is Evan, and I'm going to walk you through a high-level understanding of steel and the four major types designated by the American Iron and Steel Institute. To simplify this process, we're going to use the acronym CAST. That includes carbon, alloy, stainless, and tool steel.
Carbon steel. As the name indicates, the main alloying ingredient in this type of steel is carbon. Carbon steel is highly versatile, and its uses and properties vary depending on its carbon content. As the carbon content rises, the steel becomes harder and stronger. However, it does become less ductile, more brittle, and harder to weld. Also, the higher the carbon, the lower the melting point of the steel.
Carbon steel is further broken down into four groups based on carbon content: lower mild, medium, high, or ultra high.
Also known as mild steel, low-carbon steel contains approximately 0.04 to 0.3% carbon. Because of this, it's malleable, ductile, tough, very easy to weld, and one of the cheaper forms of steel. An example would be 1018 steel. Medium carbon, with carbon content ranging from 0.31 to 0.6%, is stronger and harder than mild steel, but is more difficult to weld and form. It is common on large parts, forged parts, and automotive components. A common example is 1045. High or carbon tool steel generally has a range of 0.61 to 1.5% carbon. This material is extremely hard and brittle, and because of this, it's very difficult to bend, weld, or cut. Lastly, ultra-high carbon steel has a carbon content ranging from 1.51 to 2% and can be heat-treated to exceptional hardness. Specialist knives, axles, and punches are typically made from ultra-high carbon steel.
Technically, every steel is an alloy, but not all steels are alloy steels. This term refers to steels that have been alloyed with elements in addition to carbon.
The most common elements include manganese, chromium, nickel, silicon, boron, molybdenum, and vanadium. Adding other elements to iron and carbon can improve a range of properties including strength, hardness, toughness, wear resistance, corrosion resistance, and hardenability. Alloy steels are broken down into two groups: low alloy and high alloy. Low alloy steels range from 1 to 5% in alloy content and are easily weldable with the appropriate precautions. High-strength low alloy are not made to chemical composition, but to mechanical properties. And high alloy steels have alloy levels in excess of 10%. This gives them outstanding properties.
Stainless steel is a steel that has a minimum of 10.5% chromium. This high chromium and carbon content are what gives stainless steel its iconic corrosion resistance, strength, and hardness.
There are six main types of stainless steel: austenitic, superaustenitic, ferritic, duplex steel, martensitic, and precipitation hardening martensitic. These differences are extremely technical and often aren't very relevant outside of welding. But stay tuned for a Materials Talk video dedicated to understanding stainless. You can generally find an alloy of stainless steel for any project you could imagine. At present, there are over 150 specific alloys of stainless. This is why stainless steel is used in everything from medical equipment, cheap knives at mall kiosks, to spacecraft and airplane hulls.
Tool steel is particularly well suited for making tools due to its distinctive hardness, resistance to abrasion, and its ability to hold a cutting edge at elevated temperatures.
The four major alloying elements in tool steel are tungsten, chromium, vanadium, and molybdenum. Tool steel is often used by bladesmiths in making knives, axes, swords, and much more. According to AISI and SAE specifications, there are six major types of tool steel based around how they are hardened and what they are used for: water hardening, cold working, shock resistant, and high speed, hot working, and special purpose. These grades are also assigned a letter designation to help clarify what they are.
Thank you for watching another Online Metals video. Please subscribe to our channel or leave a comment below with questions or future video requests.